That's a mother who is going to a tree to guard her infant, who is in a tree just around the corner. And so I go and I hide behind a bush and I wait for her to come back, and I know she's not going to leave her young alone, because a raccoon can climb up and get him or something. I start with the symbolic eagles, because we use them for their snarly, fierce aggression. Well, at least they get an olive branch as well as arrows. But it's interesting how the public imagination is seized upon eagles. And it's reliable, it delivers the mail. So Charlie Todd at Inland Fish and Wildlife used to monitor eagles when they were an endangered species from DDT that killed them off. There were very few pairs east of the Mississippi in the early 80s. And I went to bat for them. And here's a map of former eagle nests, and the green are the current eagle nests. So there's one on Falls Point, one on Bering Island, two on Butler Point, very close together, and one up on Round Island in Franklin. So that's pretty good. Five pairs of eagle. Each one of them takes about a square mile of hunting territory to feed its young. And the eagle who is here, 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 and here, and here, is the Bering Island eagle. So they've moved around the bay. This, when the subdivision came, they were up here and built a road for Schoodick Overlook, 34-lot subdivision, and that drove them over there. And then eventually, when they decided herons were tasty, they moved out there. So that shows nesting sites where they moved from time to time. So that's four nesting sites, and sometimes there are five. I think these nests are connected to these nests. I think that's offspring from one of these. So they tolerate each other. They've got to look sharp, because they're pretty invisible much of the time. You have to really look for them. But when they're in the air, you can't miss them. This eagle is hunting. This is January, and it's in January, February, March, and April. It feeds on ducks that come down from Canada to mate in Taunton Bay, and those are diving ducks that eat mussels. So the mussels end up in the same place, but the diet of the eagle turns to fish then more in the summertime, and you see it trying to catch something out of the bed.
What about turkeys? If an eagle can get a heron, can you get the hundreds of
You'd
turkeys?
You'd think so,
but
the turkey
around
is such a blundering animal that it couldn't take off. I'm assuming, but it's a scavenger. You know, if there's a deer carcass, and there are a lot of dead birds around the bay that just die in the course of living their life, and the eagle always comes and cleans up. And I think that's what they survive on a lot, is because they're scavengers and will eat anything. And I remember one duck hunting, well, the goose hunting crew came down from Bangor, and they killed 24 Canada geese and took three of them and left the other on the shore. And I was outraged at these guys. They were just mass slaughter. But they were out to kill, and they did. And then the eagle had good eating, you know, after that. Here's the bay is frozen over, but the eagle is still around in the wintertime. Here are the ducks that come down from the Northland, And here's a crack between Bering Island and Bering Island ledge, the seal popping ledge, looks like that in the wintertime. And these guys land in the crack, there's a foot wide, go down, eat mussels, come up. And suddenly, when the eagle is on the scene, they fly away. And that drama plays out every day, all winter long. The eagle trying to get enough to eat, and this is a hungry eagle, but it's not feeding young. So we get golden eyes, that's what these are. And when the eagle catches one, here's where the tail break, here's the leading edge of the wing, carrying one of those ducks. And this is what the eagle made of it. And then the eagle took off, and the fox came and ate all the bloody snow. So at least it was all used up. And you see this in the wintertime on the ice, big splotchy areas where the eagle has landed on the ice to eat the duck. Like that. You know, just out in nowhere, it just would sit there. And you get, and really, when the northeast wind is blowing, or north wind, you get a flock of 100 Canada geese out on the ice, hunkered down with their head and the necks under their wings, just trying to stay warm. And the wind would be howling, and they'd be sitting out there on the raw ice. I was very impressed with their staying power. So I saw that a lot. It was an eagle using its wings to lift something too heavy for it to really get out, and that's a big piece of meat. I couldn't tell what it was. And here are two that have killed something here, and he is waiting for her to finish up so that she can have her turn. I showed you this. She is singing to him. He comes out of the snowstorm, lands on the branch next to her, and they sing. Her mouth is open, his is open. The most beautiful serenade I have ever heard from a bird that usually sounds like a rusting Quonset hut date or something. But they really are melodious when they're in love. It's a beautiful thing. And this is January, February sometime. And look how scrawny he looks compared to her. She's big and hefty, and he's the tercel, a third smaller, lean and tough. So this is their romance, where they sit next to each other. You don't see that very often. They don't risk it very often, because it's dangerous, because they could both get in trouble. And she flies down. Look how big she looked compared to him. So she was there originally, then she took off. Then they flew together, wingtip to wingtip. And there, she is upside down, they're holding talons, and he is flying along right side up.
That's an amazing picture.
Isn't that amazing?
Oh, yes.
I was so amazed to see it, I stumbled around with my camera and at least got that.
Oh.
Just to show that it happens. But that's part of their mating ritual, to show that they are pledging their troth one to the other. And we can make it together as a unit. And it's just such a stirring, you know, to go from that to that. And you can tell from the plaintive cry of the female who's on the nest in the summertime when she's sitting on the egg. She's calling him, her mate, her lover, this guy who's important to her. And she's not calling anybody else.
Because they both participate in feeding him, don't they, male and female?
Yeah, they both feed, and they, but I think the male is supposed to do it, but I think sometimes the female is the better hunter. So they both
but not all birds do that with a female and the male participating.
Right. I don't think sandpipers, for instance, do that. So here's the nest that the subdivision road was built under, the biggest nest on the bay. That has been there for years, built up and repaired. and that was the home of the pair. And that's why I went before the planning board in Hancock to protest the building of 34 lot subdivision under, and they turned me down, and then the appeals board turned me down and said I didn't have standing, so I took it to Superior Court, and they ruled I did have standing, but the Nature Conservancy came in and offered the developer equal, an interest fee loan to build where there weren't eagles. And so that land went to the state of Maine.
Wow.
And of course the eagles left. I talked to the guy in Inland Fish and Wildlife, and he said, as soon as you protect the land, the animal you're trying to protect leave. That seems to be an unwritten law. But the eagles come and they use these trees and they sit in them, but they don't nest there. That's one in an oak tree, which is really rare. Usually they're a white pine tree. And that's an oak tree on Butler Point. And there's a young eagle who is mottled black and brown. And here's Mama off in a neighboring tree protecting it at a distance so it's not alone. That's a young. And it gets more adventurous and climbs branches, just like the herons do. And this is the maiden flight. One, that's its first flight to a neighboring tree. And that's what a young one looks like. It's mottled. It looks almost like an X-ray. You can almost see the bones underneath, under the white discolored area. But they kind of look like that for 2 years and don't get the white feathers till third, fourth, and fifth year. And occasionally they lose a feather and they have to wait to grow it back. This is one hatched that year before that, the winter I took the picture. And there's open water here, there's a pool of water, and a duck has landed there and has dived down. And the eagle has come, and this is an immature eagle who knows nothing about hunting and knows nothing about duck. And it hovers, working very hard, right over where the duck went down. And every time, the duck came up behind it. And it couldn't go in reverse, so the duck was smarter than the eagle. And the duck would gulp air and then dive down again. And finally, the eagle would be exhausted and go off and stand in the ice, and the duck would fly away. So, you know, you got to cheer for the underdog, and sometimes they do pretty good. See, he's reaching for the duck, and the duck comes up right behind him. And then he sits on the ice, looks up, Mama, Daddy, where are you? Come feed me, I'm hungry. And it's a cruel world to have to learn to feed yourself. What if we did that with our children? We put them on the street and said, take care of yourself when you're a year old. You'd never make it. So then it finally takes off and gives up. This is three eagles from the year before that hatched. This is a year later they come back. And the only reason they tolerate each other is because they're siblings. And I showed you that earlier on. And it was great fun watching them cavort together. Then one took off. I watched this one for half an hour trying to catch a fish in Egypt Bay, and it would hover and go down and dive just like the immature eagle. Missed the fish was smarter than it was, but the fish, you know, the water is only this deep, so the fish couldn't get away, so it, but here it is, exhausted. I give up, I can't take this anymore.
And these, what are they, how big are they? I know they're big.
This is 6 feet, that's an eagle wingspan. They're as big as I am. I mean, if you can picture a wingspan that big,
yeah.
It's impressive.
Interesting thing that I heard about, their eyeball is the same size as a human eyeball.
Oh, it does.
And it's sharper, it's keener than ours.
Wow.
Because they can look a mile away and see a fish under the water. You know, they're just incredible creatures. So they deserve to survive. I'm glad they're our national emblem and the turkey isn't, because I don't want to.
I didn't know our national bird was a scavenger. But
it has a certain toughness and stature about it. But its use is for its militancy in all those emblems I showed you at first. You know, the Israeli Air Force uses three eagles. And that's typical of the shots I get of blur coming out of a tree. There it is with its heron.
You talk about eagles taking turkeys. There's a really good YouTube video about an eagle trying to take a turkey, and this turkey is so persistent in the way it's dodging it and flapping back at it and stuff. So I don't know whether they do prey on turkeys, but this one didn't get taken.
And herons sometimes outsmart them, but they herons they are able to get.
It's every line. Feathers in that tail. Wonderful.
See, it needs lift when it takes off into the air from leaping off a branch, so it spreads its tail to see every feather. But they have a hard life because everybody hates eagles. Uh-huh. Seagulls and crows and blue jays will harass them, get behind them like this one, and peck at the back of the neck. The bird is just flying, and the bird had no defense. Once I saw an eagle flip around, grab the crow in his talons, and it went out for the crow. So it can get him, but usually it's too trifling, and it's not worth the trouble. But I see that as much as anything else. So they pay for their pinnacle. So this was the tree where I took the picture of it leaping off, because it's hunting right there at low tide. And I came up to the island next to this. This is Woodchuck Island. Kenneth Crabtree told me it was Woodchuck Island, because he saw, and indeed there was a woodchuck nest over here in the side of the island. But I was down here under this tree, aimed at the eagle up there, and I hoped it would come out this direction. And the first time it went out that direction.
Steve, my husband and I one time were kind of looking, it was getting close to the alewife run, and it was actually starting, and we were watching eagles and ospreys interact, and it seemed, if I remember right, the ospreys were kind of chasing the eagles, and my husband's interpretation was that they were hoping the eagle would drop the fish they had caught, so they
could. Well, that's the game the eagles play with ospreys.
Oh, maybe I had to have it backwards.
Because an eagle will be over here watching an osprey soaring above, it dives down and gets its fish. And then just as it comes up and it's having this heavy load and it's trying to shift from one medium into another, the eagle swoops in and grabs it out of its talon.
And I always got mad at the ospreys when they came back, because the eagles stay all year in West Bay.
Yeah.
And then the osprey comes back and I thought, oh, they've given the eagles a terrible time, but you say they weren't.
It usually is the eagle giving, harassing the osprey.
That wasn't close enough to discern which.
And once I saw an osprey, I'll never forget this, I didn't get a picture of it, but the osprey had a fish, and it uses the updraft from the cliffs on Bering Island to help it carry its fish up to rise. So it rides along the face of the cliff, and there was a blue jay sitting on a branch on the cliff looking. And the osprey came, and it had the fish in one talon, and it swiped at the blue jay with its other talon, and it missed. But I thought, boy, it just caught the fish, and it was feeling, I'm the mighty hunter. And it just said, I want that bird. So, you know, it's a tough world out there. You got to be on your guard all the time.
Take advantage of every opportunity, you know.
But it's kind of like living in Washington, D.C., I think. I think we're pretty good at harassing one another, making life impossible. So, okay, well, I'm glad I got all three. I don't. What's the time here?
I have 5 of 4 today.
It's what?
I have 5 of 4.
Oh, right. Perfect.
It worked out. That's what
I have. I was hoping I could do that, and it worked out. So. That's my payback for giving you an empty hour last year.
Should I turn this off then, Steve? Or we...
Yeah. Nothing more happening.